all have plan B in life, but we don't have plan B. Earth is something which is common between all of us. Hello everyone, today myself Guru Bhandari, team leader of project titled Green Building Rating of JIET College, is going to share some valuable information, figures, facts, conclusions and future opportunities for you.
And I am Lakshya Singh Solanki, a fellow teammate, is going to share the information about project outcomes and results.
Now let's begin with our presentation. By hearing the name of the title, most of you have thought that a building painted green or fully planted is known as green building. But it's much more than that. A building which uses efficiently and effectively the materials, energy and water with proper site design, universal accessibility and human comfort, it termed as a green building. It follows the main principles of sustainability, which are functional, economical and aesthetic. The purpose of our project was to reduce the high carbon emissions with renewable energy utilization, to recycle the wastewater generated, and third, to adopt the green measures. Objectives of project. First, rating of building. Second, suggestions and improvements. Rating procedure has followed. Now, I will tell you about green buildings are defined on certain sections and criteria. Agencies are GRIA, IGBC and LEED respectively. We have followed GRIA rating system because it is indigenously developed in India. It is based on Indian climatic conditions and it's our national rating system. Now I'm going to tell you an interesting fact, which is if your building is green building certified, then you get 7.5 to 15% FAR floor area ratio by government authorities. Based on GRIA existing building rating system, we have to analyze 7 sections which include 12 criteria. The project area is South Campus of JIET College. Project duration 90 to 120 days.
Now I would like to captivate you all for the project outcomes discussion and the result obtained. Following the GRIHA Green Building Rating Code for existing building, I have analyzed my college building and I found that in past few years, my college has adopted various measures to obtain which can obtain the green building rating. Like, we have 400 kilowatt of solar system installed. We have rainwater harvesting system. The surface reflectance index is restricted to 55%, which reduces the urban island heat effect. And we have the lush green environment too. But yet, these measures are not up to the benchmark of GRIHA Code of Conduct. As we know, Jodhpur district of Rajasthan is located at the arid region of the country where major focus is laid on energy and water. So on this, the area of suggestions are in energy efficiency. We need to plant the BEE rated energy appliances as well as the energy efficient technologies. We need to implant 450 kilowatt of solar system more to have the net zero efficient energy. In water efficiency, we need to retrofit the water efficient fixtures and we need to have the wastewater treatment plant for net zero water demand. Other than that, we need to adopt universal accessibility policy for the ease of access to the specially abled persons. And last, metering and monitoring should be focused on for the resource consumptions. Coming on the results, following the GRIHA's sections and criterias, the obtained points are as follows.
Conclusions. As we know, sustainability is also making ground in India, where local market is forecast to reach nearly $60 billion revenues in 2022. Educational institutions can set up training and research center in field of green buildings, rating and development, both public and private sector universities. Strategies to promote green building technologies. And last, contribution towards sustainable development goals adopted by Niti Aayog 2030 and also associated with UN 17 Sustainable Development Goals. Now, the most important and last part of our presentation, future opportunities involved for all you personals watching this video. First, be a GRIHA certified professional, because this whole rating process involves the professional team which work upon the projects. Second, you can be green building consultant services, it being provided by Godrej and multinational companies in India. Third, you can run a startup, do entrepreneurship in sustainable infrastructure development. As we all know, Ola Electric Mobility, it's a future factory. green ventures and many more in the industries. And at last, vast scope for environmental engineers to work in public and private sectors both. Thank you so much.
And at last, I must tell you that the Earth has been so kind to us, but it's the time for us to be kind to Earth. Thank you for sincerely watching this video.